Okay, so it's been a while. I'm alive, I'm not dead, still got the beard, cut all my hair off. It's going well. Today I'm going to tell you a little story about the weirdest experience I think I've ever had in my life. And we've come to exactly the right place in which where it happened. We're in my hometown of Penzance, and here is possibly the weirdest UFO story you're going to hear. In the past I've done videos on the weirdest ghost stories I've got, but this is about a UFO story. And I'm not saying that this is aliens, like definitely not saying that at all. I'm just saying it's an unidentified flying object. So any object that's in the sky that you can't describe or you can't identify, that's a UFO. And this is basically what this story is. So I'm in Penzance, as I said, and Penzance has this strip along what is known as the promenade, which is an area that's just in front of the sea and just in front of Lidl's. Good old-fashioned Lidl's, eh? But about, I don't know, maybe, how old am I? I'm 27, so this probably happened when I was about 17. So maybe 10 years ago, 11 years ago, something about that. I used to walk this pathway all the time because my ex-girlfriend used to live in the neighboring village and I used to go and visit her house. But during the winter time, this place is prime for stargazing. Now, the reason it's prime for stargazing is because there's no light. Like Penzance and Cornwall, just in, you know, the area where I live in general, is really known for being quite rural and having very little like light pollution. So the amount of stars you can see is unbelievable. But this particular patch has got very little light pollution, full stop. And what I did is it still recording, by the way?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. What I did when I was younger was I walked down this path, as I said, and I would look up at the stars like every night, just for 5 minutes, just to have my little nerd out, looking at Orion and his fancy belt with his sword and his bow and arrow. I know I used to do this all the time. And this one particular night, I noticed that there were tons and tons of red things floating in the sky. And when I say loads, I mean probably, I don't know, 50? There was about 50 of them just floating in the sky all the time. And it was then when I realized, oh, this is lanterns, they're Chinese lanterns, and it's to celebrate some kind of Chinese thing. Maybe New Year, I can't really remember, but I remember it being prevalent at the time. So this is on like a really weird corner where there's a flight of stairs in a minute, I'll show you all about it in a second, and then there's this long path. But in this bit, back 10 years ago, before the floodlights were here for the skate park, there was literally no light. And I'd look up at the stars, look at the sky, saw the lanterns. But when you walk through this bit, because it's so dark, I would take my headphones out. And I'd take my headphones out because I wanted to have my wits about, just in case something happened. And nothing happened. And this isn't where the UFO thing occurs. This happens a little bit further down. I don't know, just some ideas. Come on. No, we're not filming yet. One bit that is lit fam, is this pathway, which is the main road in and out of Newlyn, the neighboring village. So this particular night, as I walked down those stairs that I showed you, I put back in my headphones because I was able to be in the light and I wasn't in any grave danger at the time. So when I got to about here, that's when I saw something really weird. So just behind me there's a house. Is it there? Look at the thing.
No.
This house here. I'm walking along this road and I see what can only be described as a giant blimp. It's a blimp that's bigger than the house, and it's enormous. I think if I had to guess size, I'd say it's probably twice the size of that house. It really was. It was a giant, giant thing in the sky. And because I had my headphones in, I didn't really know what was going on. But as I got closer, I realized that the UFO, whatever it is, was blurry with or without my glasses on, because bispectacular individual. So it was blurry even when I was here and I could see it. And I was trying to take take my glasses on and off, and it was still blurry. I took my headphones out, it wasn't making a noise. But the most weird thing about this whole situation wasn't the fact that it was blurry, it wasn't the fact that it was ginormous, it wasn't making a noise, is that I felt kind of like an electric in the air. And it felt like a mixture between electricity and static. And I know static is kind of electricity, but it felt like a weird mix. So I could feel it all over my body, but it was very tactile in the way that static is. Babe, put your arm down.
My arm is so sore.
So I had this like electric sensation the whole time. And I tried to get somebody's attention, but there was no one there. There was no cars. And as you can see, there's loads of cars on this road. There's normally loads of people on this road as well. But there was no one at the time. There was just no one. So I got really close. We're not going to get any closer to the house because, you know, they probably wouldn't want two people walking up with a camera and a microphone in their face. And I got as close as I could without trespassing. And legitimately, that's not just me saying that I didn't go in the house. And because there was no one around and I didn't have a camera phone, I just had to leave. The hell was that? I just had to leave the place. And I was the only person who saw it. So obviously I didn't go anywhere near the house. And obviously, because there was no one around, there's no one to corroborate my story. But honestly, this is probably one of the weirdest experiences I've ever had, because there's no explanation, there was no noise. It was blurry when I took my glasses off and put my glasses back on, but nothing else was blurry. Like, the house was still crystal clear. And when I moved around the building, because it's on the side of a street, when I moved around it, I thought maybe it's like a trick of the light, or there's like an object that's really close to my face or something like that. So I thought maybe I'm just seeing this at a really weird perspective and it's not actually hovering over the house. But no, as I was moving around the house, because I was moving away on the path, it was still there, floating above it, right above it. So essentially that's that. That's the story. Again, not saying it's aliens, it's just an unidentified flying object. But if the individual things happened, like it was blurry, I'd understand. If it was the static feeling, I'd understand. If it was the lack of sound or the sheer size of the object, these things individually, I'd understand. But together, I really don't know what to say. And that's pretty much it for today. Thanks everyone for all your support. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for the comments that you left on the last video. I know it's been like 4 months since I did a video, but a lot has gone on in those 4 months, and I might catch up with you at some point. Yeah, thank you very much, and expect to see more content on the channel. My hand's doing this for the whole thing. I don't know why.